Welcome back. It's the 7-hour challenge and it's all about Qoderai. It's a IDE that's powered by AI. It's also a fork of VS Code and it's made by Alibaba. And today we're going to be looking at it, looking at the first look and also comparing it to cursorai. So in case you missed our previous video of our introduction and benchmark with cursorai, in this series, every day we'll try out one new tool and see how it compares to cursorai. In performance, privacy, features, and even ease of use for non-techies. At the end, we will be crowning a winner. Some of these tools below, if you recognize any of your favorite tools, do leave a comment. So it does support the Windows platform, which we're going to be looking, testing it on. Also, a Mac OS, and I heard the Linux version is in development. For pricing, it's the public preview stage, like it's in beta mode, so it's currently free. For audience, it's also for experienced developers and limitations. Since it's in beta mode, like the preview mode, a lot of bugs, but yeah, it's still decent and usable. First, all you have to do is navigate to qcoder.com and click download. I think currently it's available for Windows. And once it's done downloading, all you have to come is double click to install. And just click next, follow the prompts. So now that it's done, we're just going to be launching Qoder directly. So I'm going to click let's start. And you can decide if you're importing from Cursor. This is actually nice because a lot of us were now using Cursor and not VS Code. But I was still importing from VS Code. So let's just confirm and continue. So it's done importing settings and needs me to decide between Qoder, the different themes. I feel like this information you could have found out from VS Code. But let's just proceed. Yeah, and if I want to sign in or later, so I would just sign in. So I'm signing up, and once I'm done creating my account, I have to open the ID, which should open automatically. Okay, yeah, so sign in successful. After that, I just open a project. So we just looked GPT-5, yes, trust, and it's a blank project, and I have to click this to talk my chat. That's quite slow. It's literally a blank project. Why does it need to? But see, this is the first look. Let's keep our minds open. So I thought I was signed in already. I guess that part also did not synchronize. Let's just check the settings and see what's available. Let me open this fully. Okay, we can see they have the different plans. I'm currently on the pro trial and they have the chat completions. And yes, they have MCP integrations. And MCP is where you can see different, you know, MCP, even contact, even whichever one you want, you can integrate, right? Or you can, you know, manually add it. Shake it. So you can also see for the rules, file, indexing, and even advanced. And even you can tell it the files it should not index and whatnot. So that's all quite good. So we can see the settings that are available. There's nothing about setting up the models. So once again, we have another ID that doesn't really have model transparency. You can't really select what model you want to use. We have the agents mode. We have the axe mode. And you can also add context. There's no context, right? So let's just tell it to give us a simple wishing app. Let's see what that would mean. I don't even know what that means, but let's see what that translates to. HTML, CSS, and JS. Make it pretty. So let's watch it go to work. Okay, it's done now, and we can just accept all the changes. And it wants to run a Python server. Instead, I would be ignoring this and just cancel and just run this with live server. So open with live server. And let's see the project now. Okay, so this is what we have. Just drag it in here. Wish for thoughts. Make a wish and watch it. Okay, so this is what the apps look like. Let's see. I wish I have $1 billion. Okay. Let's see what happened. Wow. And see all the whole stars animation. Okay. So on August 25th, I wished for $1 billion. Okay. Okay, and you can delete. Wow, nice icons. And you can delete your wishing. That's really cool. Okay, so there's one other thing I would like us to review, right? One other thing. I just cancel all this, you know. Okay, so we can get a summary of what has been done. Is the quest mode one thing that makes it different from cursor? I think one other AI that has this, something like this task mode is the Cairo AI. So you can come to the quest mode from here and you can click on tasks. And in this mode, you can actually say, you know what? I wanted to write the specifications for what it could do. How I would like us to add a feature where we can make users issues. Okay, you know, where we can predict the wish will come true. So I wanted to write the specifications, then, you know, implement. So let's see how this works. Okay. So wish prediction. This is quite cool. I think CairoAI too has something similar. Being able to plan your tasks in advance. And I don't know if you guys are familiar with the BMAT method. Something like that. And just execute. But let's see how they've implemented it here. If it's, you know, well done. And if it's going to be realistic. Right? Like if it's something that you would use on your day-to-day. Or if it's just another feature you would ignore. Okay. So it's working on design. And we can see designing the, you know, core functionality, feature enhancement. Okay. So would you like me to proceed with implementing this part of the design? Yeah, I think so. Yes. Please proceed. Actually, poor. It asked me about more about the design and I'm like, should it implement it? And I said, yes, implement everything. And instead of moving to the action flow, it started trying to edit my script right from the design phase of the UI, which obviously would not work. So I guess that their base prompt is buggy because you can see that did not work and it was unable to edit the file. Then instead of telling me the user that I should add this to the beginning of my script, then instead of giving me code. This is design mode. There's not supposed anything code happening here. I think this actually failed. And yeah, I don't know how to proceed from here. Am I supposed to copy the code and manually put it? This is not 20. What year was that? We copy code from ChatGPT. I am not going to do this. So yes, I think the quest mode is a failure. Maybe I don't know how to use it. Someone else could come up and, you know, in the comment section, tell me what I'm doing wrong. How did you guys use it correctly? Shouldn't I have said yes when they asked me, should he design it? Should I have said no, move to the design stage? So it's the action stage or something. I don't know. But yeah, anyway, it's in preview mode. It's in beta. Everything should not work. So let's just, you know, let's just give them a pass on that. But yeah, for I think normal code implementation, normal chat mode, normal chat and agent mode, it does work fine. And I think that's actually quite enough. Yeah, and remember, it's free in this prediction mode. And now let's go back to console. So how does this compare to console AI? So for the features, it has a chat completion, images and prompts, using MCPs and all the features you would expect in console AI. It does have them and most of them actually do work. Security-wise, you can't use the offline mode. You can't use an offline LLM, like all these local LLM. But yeah, it does have the privacy control. Although I didn't notice that the privacy control button, you can't toggle it on and off. It's just permanently toggled on that you have privacy. So I'm not even sure everything is functional, but like it's a preview stage. But so far, we can see that it does have privacy controls. For model transparency, this does not exist. They tell us that they determine the best model for the task and they use it. And sometimes they use a cloud, Gemini, or even GPT. I know they use the Qoder coder too. So all that is in news, but there's no transparency on what's really going on under the hood. For pricing, everything is still free for now. So we can see all the models they mentioned they use and all these other ones, you know, are not in use. So let's look at the comparison table for performance agent models, you know, security. And we can see it does have this models security. Yeah, there's a privacy mode, but, you know, it's partially unclear. And for the custom API, that's not there. It is free and does have MCP integration. So you can see also has agent mode and whatnot. So that's the conclusion of today's video. And tomorrow we're going to be looking at Winsoft. Do like and subscribe and leave your comments. Have you tried Qoder? Will you be trying it? And if you have any questions or video recommendations, thank you.